Bam! Mr. Taru, do you have a series involving nth powers? Well then, I've got the test for you, and that is called the root test. This will be the last test that we put into our toolbox before moving on to Taylor polynomials. We have been looking at series and determining whether they converge or diverge using a, recognizing that they're geometric series, telescoping series. We have done the p-series test, the integral test, the alternate series test, the limit comparison test, the direct comparison test, the ratio test, and in your book it's probably in the same section like it is in mine, but we have here with the root test. And it says, let the summation of a sub n be a series. And that series converges absolutely if the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of n is less than 1. And I'm only going to do two examples. It'll be a pretty quick video. Neither example, though, involves like an alternating series or has any negative values. But if you have like a negative 1 to the n minus 1 power or something like that, the absolute values is going to take care of that. Our series is going to diverge if the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n is either greater than 1 or infinity. And then finally, if you get a limit that's equal to 1, well, then you've done some work, but you have more work to do because the test is inconclusive. We have not determined whether the series converges or diverges. Maybe move on to, say, maybe an alternating series test or direct comparative test or something like that. But here we have example 1. It is the summation where n goes starts at 1 and goes to infinity of 3 to the n plus 2 power, 3n plus 2 over 2n minus 1 to the nth power. Now, if that nth power was not there, we would just do the limit as n approaches infinity of 3n plus 2 over 2n minus 1, and the nth term test would fail because that limit is not equal to 0. But we have that little bit extra complication there with a power of n. So the entire expression in my series has that nth power. Let's see what happens when we do the root test. So we're going to be looking at the limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n. Again, I don't have any kind of negative 1 to the nth power. Probably should just went ahead and put that in there. But that would get canceled out anyway by the absolute value. Now, this power of n and this root of n are going to go ahead and cancel out. Now, if this power and this root are even, then the power and the even root are going to act as an absolute value symbol, but of course we already have those here. So now we're looking at the limit as n approaches infinity of 3n plus 2 over 2n minus 1, nth root part of this root test is actually, now that it's been canceled, we're kind of like going to that nth term test to see if the series converges or diverges. And here we're going to have infinity over infinity, but you can divide the numerator and denominator or multiply through the numerator and denominator 1 over n to get it into a format that allows us to plug in infinity, or you can apply L'Hopital's rule and take the derivative of the numerator and the derivative of the denominator individually. And however you approach this problem, of course, this is a pretty simple limit to analyze. It's going to come out to be 3 halves. Now, 3 halves is greater than 1, and so therefore, by the ratio test, the given series diverges. And at least out of the textbook I'm teaching from and the problems I'm going to assign, all these are problems that these series that you can test using the root test do have a pretty simple or short simplification process. That's why this video is only a couple of examples long, but our second example is going to take a little bit more work to find that limit as n approaches infinity. And it doesn't involve any negative values requiring the absolute value symbol, but it is a more interesting question than this one. And for our second and last example, we have the summation where n starts at 1 and goes to infinity of n over 2 to the n. And unlike our first example that had a power of n in the numerator and the denominator, which admittedly was a pretty simple example, we just have that power of n in the denominator. So maybe the root test wouldn't be your first, you know, go-to test to try and analyze whether the series converges or diverges. And to be honest, I haven't tried to test, use all of the other tests on this series. We're just going to see what happens when we try to apply the root test. Because it's nice, and when it works, it's just nice and easy. Is a limit of the, well, let's do it. The limit as n approaches infinity of the nth root of the absolute value of a sub n does that come out to be less than 1? Does the series converge by the root test? Well, n is starting at 1 and going to infinity, and this is of course a series, which means that n will never be negative. So these absolute value symbols, you know, the absolute value of this expression is simply this expression, n over 2 to the n. Now we're going to rewrite this, basically this radical, with a fractional or rational exponent. Just showing all of the steps because honestly, you know, I need them. Okay, so, you know, basically just a power of 1 here, nth root, we got 1 over n. Applying that power to both the numerator and denominator using the power to power rule. And then, of course, n times 1 over n is just going to be 1. So we're taking, well, we have basically a factor of 1 in the numerator, so we have 1 half times n to the 1 over n power. So we can bring that 1 half out front. And let's see what we have. Well, as we let n approach infinity, we've got n is approaching infinity, so it's approaching infinity, and our exponent's going to be 1 over infinity, which is 0. Zero or infinity to the zero power is one of the forms of indeterminate we learned in just a few sections ago when we were talking about L'Hopital's rule. So we need to kind of take this out here to the side and say, do some scratch work. We have y is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity of n to the 1 over n. Let's try and manipulate this so we can get it into a form that will allow us to apply L'Hopital's rule, because we can't do it right now. We need like a 0 over 0 or infinity over infinity, right? To allow us to apply that L'Hopital's rule, we got a variable base and a variable exponent. Okay, we need to move that exponent, so we need logarithms to allow us to do that. So we're going to take the natural log of both sides. Now, that's going to allow us to bring out this exponent of 1 over n out in front of the natural log function. Now, let's see what we have right now. If we let n approach infinity now, we have 0 times infinity. So we've manipulated this, this expression, basically, into just another form of indeterminate that still does not allow us to use L'Hopital's rule. We need that 0 over 0 or that infinity over infinity. We need some kind of fractional format. So let's turn this multiplication of 1 over n into a division. Show that, you know, multiplying by 1 over n is effectively dividing by n, right? So now, when we try and find the limit, we have still another form of an indeterminate, but we have infinity over infinity, which is an indeterminate form that allows us to use L'Hopital. So we have y using, and I'm just going to do kind of like a little L apostrophe H to let people know that I'm doing L'Hopital's rule, and we have the natural log of y is equal to the limit as n approaches infinity. The derivative of the natural log of n, of course, is 1 over n. The derivative of n is equal to 1. And now, as we let n approach infinity, we come out to be equal to 0. Oh, okay. So we have one half. Well, let's get, actually, we don't have, hello, come back here. We still have to take care of this natural log of y that we had going on. So we have the natural log of y is equal to 0. Okay, why? Okay, that's interesting. The natural log of y is equal to 0. I kind of stopped this problem so I could work with that, write that limit notation, which I said equal to y. I need to know what y is equal to. So we're going to make both sides an exponent of e, and we have y is equal to e to the first, which is 1. So that means that 1 half times the limit as n approaches infinity of n to the 1 over n power is equal to 1 half times 1, which is equal to 1 half. Now 1 half is less than 1, so therefore, by the ratio test, our series does what? Converges. Absolutely, even though there was never going to be negative in the first place. I missed true. That's the root test. I'm looking up here like the name's still there. Anyway, let's try this again. I missed true. Go to your homework.